Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will get an overview of the technology which is known as LIDAR. So this LIDAR is the acronym of the term light detection and ranging. So now, as its name suggests, this technology uses the light waves or the light source to measure the distance between the objects. Or in another way, we can say that it is used in the range finding applications. So now this is not a new technology, and in fact it is being used since last more than 50 years. And in 1960s, it was first used to measure the distance between the moon and the earth using the lasers. And nowadays, it is being used in so many applications. And maybe in the future, you will see that your self-driving car will be equipped with this LIDAR system. Now, if you see this term LIDAR, it sounds very familiar with the term that is known as the radar, and many of you might be already knowing about this radar system. So now, in terms of the working principle, this LIDAR and radar both are quite similar. So let us find out in this video what is LIDAR, how it works, and what are the different applications of this LIDAR system, and how it is different from the radar system. So first of all, let us understand how this LIDAR system works. So now, if you see any LIDAR system, the laser and the detector are the two of the main components which you see inside this LIDAR system. And most of the LIDAR systems works on the principle of time of flight. So in this principle, the laser in the pulse form is targeted on the object, and the reflection or the scattering from the object, it is being measured by the detector. And at the detector side, the timing between the transmitted pulse and the received pulse is measured. So let us say the distance between the LIDAR system and the object is capital D. So now if we know the timing difference between the arrival and the transmitted pulse, then using this simple mathematics, we can calculate the distance between the LIDAR system and the object. And here, this velocity of this transmitted light pulse will be at the rate of speed of light. So this is the basic principle how every LIDAR system works. So now if you see the working principle of radar system, even radar system works on the same principle, that is time of flight principle. So now let us exactly understand what is the difference between this LIDAR system and the radar system. So now if you see the term radar, it stands for the radio detection and the ranging. So instead of light waves, in case of the radar system, the radio waves are used for the measurement. So now if you see the electromagnetic spectrum, then you will notice that the radio waves which are used in the radar system are millimeter waves, while the light waves which are used in the LIDAR system are almost 3 order less in dimension than the radio waves. So these radio waves cannot detect the objects which are very small in the dimension. While using the light waves, we can even detect the very small objects. So using this LIDAR system, we can achieve the much more precision. So because of its precision, these LIDAR systems are used for the 3D mapping of the object or even for the surface scanning of the object. And using this LIDAR system, we can even scan the buildings as well as the different terrains. While the radar systems are used in applications where the exact size and shape of the object is not important, but the detection distance is more important. So basically they are used in military applications or in air traffic control, where the detection of the object is more important rather than the size and shape of the object, or even they are used in some range finding applications. Now the advantage of radar over LIDAR is that it works even in the harsh environment. So it even works in case of the rain, fog or even snow, while the LIDAR system cannot work in such harsh environment. So now whenever we are discussing the different technologies which are used for the range finding, so let us also mention the one more technology which is used for the range finding, which is known as the sonar. So in this sonar technology, instead of the radio waves or the light waves, the acoustic waves are used for the range finding or measuring the distance. And mainly this technology is used for the underwater applications. Alright, so here is the quick comparison between the LIDAR and the radar system. So as I said earlier, apart from the range finding application, this LIDAR is also used for the 3D mapping of the object or even for the surface scanning. So there has to have some mechanism by which we can rotate this light source so that we can scan the object. So now let us understand using this radar system how the objects can be scanned. So let us say here we have an object and we want to measure the depth profile of this object. So in this way, using this LIDAR system, we can get the depth profile of that object. Now here, the resolution of this depth profile depends upon the scanning angle of this LIDAR system as well as the number of samples which is being taken by this LIDAR system. So lesser will be the scanning angle, the more accurate will be the depth profile of that object. So that is being said, now let us see the different components of LIDAR system. Now some of the components we have already mentioned earlier. So the first component is the laser. Now most of the lasers which are used for this LIDAR system are in the range of near infrared. But in some applications, like in underwater applications, even green lasers are also used. Now the second component of this LIDAR system is the detector, which consists of the photodiode circuit to measure the reflected or the scattered light which is coming from the object. Then the third component of this LIDAR system is the optics or the rotating mechanism to scan the object. Apart from that, we used to have the timing electronics to measure the difference between the transmitted pulse and the received pulse. So as I said earlier, this LIDAR system used to generate the enormous amount of data points in real time. So to compute that data, we also require the computer. So apart from these components, the GPS and the IMU, which stands for the inertial measurement unit, are also part of this LIDAR system. So this GPS and IMU are particularly useful when we have airborne LIDARs. That means the LIDAR system is being fitted either in the helicopter or aeroplane, or maybe even drone, and sometimes maybe even in the satellites. And these airborne LIDARs are particularly useful to scan the particular terrain. So that being said, now let us see the different applications of this LIDAR system. So as I said earlier, apart from the range finding applications, this LIDAR can be used for the 3D mapping as well as the surface scanning. So this LIDAR system can be used for the 3D mapping of any building. So in this way, just by scanning the building, we can get the profile of that building in a digital form. So apart from that, this LIDAR system can be used for the police trafficking for the measurement of the vehicle speed. Now so far, the radar guns were used for the measurement of the vehicle speed, but because of its higher accuracy nowadays, the radar guns have been replaced by these LIDAR guns. So apart from the range finding application, this LIDAR system can be used for the agriculture research, and using this, we can help the farmers to find the area which can give them maximum yield. So now apart from measuring the profile of terrain, it is also used in the automobile industry. So as I said earlier, you might see this LIDAR system in your upcoming self-driving cars, where it can be used to scan the object in front of it in real time, and using that it can make the decision accordingly. So apart from the automobile industries, this LIDAR system is also used in designing the video games. For example, the company ESport is using this LIDAR point clouds to create the most realistic three-dimensional environment of golf, basketball, as well as the football stadiums. And here is the example of a LIDAR point cloud of a very famous Madison Square Garden. So in this way, this LIDAR system can be used in almost all the fields. And if we count the applications, then list will go on. So I hope in this video, you got an overview of this LIDAR technology. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.